Hello everyone, I'm Gurmeet Kaur, a postdoctoral fellow at the NIH, and today I'm going to talk about some novel, highly regulated and diverse biological conflict systems with implications for emergence of multicellularity. All living organisms are in a constant state of conflict with others in their surroundings, competing for a limited set of resources and resulting in survival of the fittest. Every genome is armed to encounter conflict. Effector responses or biomolecular weaponry generally takes two forms. They can either belong to a diverse array of RNases, DNases, peptidases, or other modifying enzymes that directly attack the invader or self-biomolecules, or they can be membrane pore-forming toxins that rupture the attacking cell. Proteins involved in conflict generally display high domain architecture variability, differences even among closely related organisms, and effectors in particular show extreme diversity in sequence and structure, indicative of them being under intense natural selection to adapt to host pathogen interactions. Counter-invasive conflict systems have two main components. First are the sensors that detect the invasive element and activate the other primary component, that are the effectors that generate a defense response. However, undue effector deployment can be fitness compromising for the host and needs to be tightly regulated. One such mechanism is by setting a threshold for activation of effectors. From previous studies in our group, we had anecdotal evidence for the involvement of proteins of the AAA plus ATPase family in effector deployment by creation of a threshold energy activation barrier. Continuing our exploration of conflict systems, we came across a number of systems in which chaperone of the MOXR ATPase family and its co-chaperone, the VWA domain-containing protein, constitute a part of the core of these systems. Besides these two, there was at least one more component in the core of these systems. Based on the identity of this third component, we detect four different subsystems. The first of these subsystems that we call the classical ternary systems have a third protein that we term the VMAP, which is an abbreviation for VWA MOXR associated protein. VMAP is an interesting protein that is confined to only these subsystems and contains both constant and variable domains. The variable regions likely help in sensing diverse invaders, and the constant regions relay this information to other core components. Thereafter, the MOXR is likely to cause an ATP-dependent activation and release of effector fused at the C-terminal of the VWA domain. Additional regulation is likely provided by proteases or nucleotide-generating enzymes fused at the N-terminal of the VMAP. We also observe several accessory systems that likely amplify the overall response to the conflict. These include the peptide processing systems and the diversity-generating retroelements. The other three subsystems share the MOXR and VWA domains with subsystem 1, but have other components that distinguish them from each other. In subsystem 2, the third component is an inactive version of STAN domain of the STAN subclade of the AAA plus ATPases, while in subsystem 3, it is an FTSH domain that again belongs to the AAA plus ATPases superfamily. And in subsystem 4, it is a beta propeller containing protein. We also detected transmembrane regions in constituent proteins of subsystem 2 and 4 that indicate their activity near the cell membrane. While these four subsystems have their own set of distinguishing components, they all carry out the same basic steps of invader sensing, ATP-dependent activation, and effector deployment. We were also able to detect analogous systems depicted here by systems 2, 3, and 4. In systems 2, we found members of the GTPA superfamily that are likely to perform thresholding role of effector activation. In these systems, we find two paralogous copies of the GTPAs that we term the double or DOGTPAs. These are further divided into two subtypes depending on the identity of the second conserved component of these systems that we call the GTPase associated protein 1 or GAP 1. In systems 3 and 4, the effector deployment is likely controlled by proteolytic activation by the trypsin and caspase proteases. Although at first glance these systems may appear distinct, but they do share features pointing to unifying mechanistic principles. All of these systems have a combination of constant and highly variable components. All of them are under tight regulation by ATPases, GTPases or peptidases switches. Additional regulation is often brought by associated peptidases or nucleotide-utilizing enzymatic domains. All of them have a dedicated invader sensing component, which is the VMAP, I-stand or GAP1 in their respective systems. These have both constant and variable regions to detect the invader and relay the information to other core components. The highly variable effectors belong to diverse functional categories, and we often observe inactive versions of common cellular domains as effectors. These are likely to act as decoys to engage invader biomolecules. We also observe that some effectors are not directly fused to the core proteins, but coupled to them via adaptive protein domains specific to these conflict systems, which we term effector-associated domains or EADs. The most common effectors in these systems are either superstructure-forming repeats, such as TPRs, or stand-NTPases that are similar to those seen in some plant and animal-based immune systems, animal apoptosis, and fungal heteroincompatibility systems. Further, intriguingly, we observe that 7 of the 8 systems that we describe here are primarily confined to evolutionarily diverse bacterial clades and few archaea lineages that display multicellularity and complex life forms. This thematic convergence suggests that these systems have been repeatedly convergently shaped by selective pressures co-evolving with the multiple emergences of the multicellular state, and then disseminated extensively by lateral transfers. It is also fascinating to observe several parallels between these prokaryotic systems and the eukaryotic apoptotic pathways. First, all of them are highly regulated. Second, these bacterial systems share a number of protein domains with the eukaryotic immunity systems, such as the stand-NTPases and adapters that bring about coupling of proteins. Third, several immune responses are seen to couple to combat the invader in all of these. Fourth, superstructure-forming protein domains and multimeric complexes are common to all of them. Further, it has been previously shown that several protein domains of the eukaryotic apoptotic machinery emerged in prokaryotes and then they were laterally transferred. We were able to provide evidence for one more of them, the death-like domain. We detect for the first time bacterial homologs of the eukaryotic death-like domain. These were detected as adaptive domains fused with the effectors in these systems, similar to the domain architectures and roles these perform in eukaryotes. And through sequence homology, these could be neatly unified to the eukaryotic death-like domains. I would like to now conclude by laying out the implications of our study for the emergence of multicellularity. An infection is likely to spread very quickly in multicellular aggregates once a single cell catches the infection. Thus, apoptotic mechanisms to sacrifice a single infected cell are of general importance to multicellular bodies. However, apoptosis needs to be tightly regulated, and one such mechanism is by threshold sensing. We observe a comparable set of domains organized into systems based on common principles in both eukaryotes and prokaryotes for this function. It is likely that the selection for multiple such systems went alongside the emergence of multicellularity, and their appropriate regulation is of general importance for the stability of such cellular organizational states. Thank you for your time, and I am happy to answer any questions now.